the Lord. Praise the living Jesus. If you look around where you're seated, you should find our hymn. We have our hymn books around where you're seated. If you don't have it, we'll get them to bring to you. But we'll begin the service. You can join the multimedia system also to take the hymn. But we'll begin this service as we sing from our hymn book, hymn 12. Hymn 12 from our hymn book. Praise my soul, the King of Heaven, to his feet thy tributes be. Standing, we'll hear the purpose of our gathering at this service. We are gathered here today, Saturday, 1st October, in the year of our Lord 2022, as members and friends of the Onolaja family, to acknowledge God's goodness and mercies to us all. In particular, we gather to offer our praise and thanksgiving to God for sparing the life of our beloved wife, mother, sister, aunt, and friend, Sister Rosalyn Onolaja, who is 60 years old today. We have come to declare before God our gratitude and to acknowledge our total dependence on Him for His continued blessing. Therefore, I invite you all, brothers and sisters, to join in this act of praise and thanksgiving. The Lord be with you. Let us sit on you as we pray.
pray. Our Father in heaven, the utter, invisible, the only wise God, the only faithful God, we exalt you because you are our God. You are maker, you are redeemer. You are sustainer. Father, we glorify you for giving us the grace to see today the day of life. I want to thank you for your daughter, Sister Rosalie Onalaga. I want to thank you for your protection upon her life, upon her family. We want to thank you for all of that grace that's made available for her in life. So we say, be now exalted, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. For the reality of today is your doing, is your making. We really appreciate it. I want to thank you for every battle you fought, you won for her in life. Thank you for her husband, thank you for her children, thank you for her family and the entire family of Onalaga. Thank you for friends and well-wishers. We appreciate it because it has been you in that way. And we acknowledge the fact that if not you who has been on her side, it's totally would have been a different one. But because you have been with her, we say thank you, Father. The exalted Lord in the name of Jesus. We thank you for the independence of our nation which we are celebrating today. We thank you for the entire nation of Nigeria, for him that you supported us. We thank you for everything, Lord. We say that we are exalted in the name of Jesus. In any way we have heard, in any way we have seen, Lord, we plead this morning that in your mercy, you forgive us all our shortcomings in the name of Jesus. We plead the blood of Jesus upon every soul here today. We ask for the forgiveness of even the sins of our leaders in Nigeria. May he please you this morning and forgive us, O Lord, in the name of Jesus. Everything that we shall do here this afternoon, Lord, we pray that you take preeminence via your Holy Spirit in the name of Jesus. Holy Spirit, divine, come and tabernacle in our heart. Come and tabernacle in this sanctuary. At the close of today's service, Lord, we pray that your name and only your name will be glorified. Thank you, Heavenly Lord. Blessed be thy name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed.
Praise the Lord. May I invite the servant to please come forward for the first reading, for the first lesson.
The Lord be with you. Shall we all come to the Lord? The Holy Gospel is written in the 15th chapter of the Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ as recorded by St. John, beginning at the first verse. Jesus said, I am the true vine, and my Father is the vine dresser. Every branch in me that does not bear fruit, he takes away. And every branch that bears fruit, he prunes, that it may bear more fruit. You are already clean because of the word which I have spoken to you. Abide in me, and I in you. As the branch cannot bear fruit of itself, unless it abides in the vine, neither can you unless you abide in me. I am the vine, you are the branches. He who abides in me and I in him bears much fruit. For without me, you can do nothing. If anyone does not abide in me, he is cast out as a branch and is withered. And they gather them and throw them into the fire and they are gone. If you abide in me and my word abide in you, you will ask what you desire, and it shall be done for you. By this my Father is glorified, that you bear much fruit. So you will be my disciple. This is the gospel of Christ.
Our next thing, great is thy faithfulness, O God my Father, will be transmitted on the screen.
Thank you.
today.
I mean all of us here gathered. It is deserving to praise God at all times. But for the celebrant of today, it is most deserving that God be praised. We have very many reasons for which we should and we will praise God, individual of us. But because today, in particular, we are gathered to celebrate an individual. I know there are few people or many who were born on a day such as this many years ago. The president's wife is also a birthday date of our money. And Shabalai also told us while we were coming in that one of his children was also born on a day such as this. Before we pray, for our mommy, Mommy Roslyn Onalaja, one of our patronesses in the diocese of Ijebu. This particular chorus in Yoruba is very, very applicable to your matter. Emi lo ye ki koko dupe. Emi lo ye ki koko dupe. Mo lo jo ori la ayo. Emi lo ye ki koko dupe. Because it is because of you, we are all gathered to celebrate and to give thanks to God. Another chorus in Yoruba says, oh my Lord Jere, eh, Jamala, eh, Jekomolewi, oh my Lord Jere, that the food that God eats is precious in his thanksgiving.
Verses 1 to 5 at the background.
Psalm 103 expresses his thanksgiving to God, expresses his joy to God, and he mentions, he itemized one by one some of the things the Lord did for him. In that Psalm 103, it said, he gave reason why thanking God is of a necessity. It is compulsory. It is imperative. It is not even optional in any way. By saying, praise the Lord, O my soul, all my inmost being, praise his holy name. He was talking and he was addressing himself. Praise the Lord, my soul. Everything in me, praise the Lord. He was making it a matter of must that himself, everything that is gathered up in him, to make him who he is or he was, to praise God. In verse 2, he now says, praise God, O my soul, and forget not all his goodness, forget not all his benefits. Most times, whatever we call goodness, are derived from a source other than us. At times it may be cultivated, but most especially and in many occasions, benefits come to us, not even from within us, from outside us. We have left with it. And so the man recognized that one way or the other, the Lord has favored him. The Lord has blessed him. And for that reason, praise the Lord, all my soul, and everything in me, forget not his goodness, forget not his benefits. That's what we are doing today. When we must think on Elijah, knows that all the way it has been done. Whatever it is today, it is by grace, it is by favor, it is God who has ordered it. And she knows that she will return to God. And that's why we are gathered. Among the goodness that this man, King David, talked about, he mentioned the components. What hearing contained in goodness. Goodness was a word. Good things the Lord has been doing. He mentioned some of the things that went in to make goodness what it is. And he mentioned as follows. Number one, and the celebrant read it today. The Lord forgives his sins. The way he has forgiven us our sins, and the way he has forgiven the celebrant our sins in particular. He also said, God healed all his diseases, the way he has healed all of us. Let me tell a testimony. I was very okay yesterday, and that evening I was feeling dizzy. I said, whatever the devil, whether the devil likes or not, I was here, and I'm here at the grace of God. Because God healed me, and God has healed her many times over. He ransoms us, he ransoms her from dangerous situations. When she was young, when she was growing older, she would have come across difficult situations that God ransomed her from them. God surrounds him, the psalmist said, with love and tender mercies, which he can also attest to. He fills his life with good things, the psalmist professed and expressed, which he can also
test and test two in our lives. The psalmist says, my youth is renewed like the eagles. He was getting older and he was feeling younger inside of him. When I look at my Rosemary, I believe she looks 40 at 60. That is the grace of God. It is not very common to an individual. It is uncommon. That is God in our life and in our lives. But particularly, I want to mention some areas in which God has been particularly good to her. Number one, God gave her grace of having been given back to many young, many children who are born and think back. But she was given back to. That's one. Number two, the sustaining grace of God has been on her to have grown from birth till now that she turns 60. Many people died younger. Grace of God to have met her own husband. Many people married wrongly. For the gift of children and being a grandmother, it is a grace that Lord has released on her. But one in particular that I want to thank God for in her life is that she has been given grace not to be a failure in her ministry. What is her ministry? The ministry of every woman is kept with the man. When God created Adam, he created him to be the head of the home. And he also said, I will give you an helpmeet. Any woman given in marriage to anybody, she is to support the husband in whatever the husband does. And so in that ministry of supporting the husband, she's not a failure. Whatever the husband is today is not without a support. But let me say one in particular, because when I didn't want to have a doctor, he's my man, he's my friend, and my late president. We know him for one thing. We is his strength. In the area of generous giving. Generous giving. He's a man that is addicted to helping people, sacrificially giving to people. Not that he doesn't need money, but that is his own area of ministry. If money or the like has never been supportive of him in that ministry, it will not seem crucial. I will give you an example. I was told of a particular rich man in Yoruba land. Whenever anybody comes to seek help from the husband, the man will say, you know that I don't pay the school fees of our children. She already said something like that. But she has not been doing so. That's why the generosity being exhibited by the husband is still there, because he has a supportive wife. And so in your ministry to your husband and to God, you are not a failure. By my own assessment, and I know I have the Spirit of God. Praise God. What you need you more and more? What you need you more and more? And I'm coming to a conclusion, gradually. Number one, on daily basis, surrender to God more and more. What does it entail to surrender? He will say, God, I'm at your bidding. I have no authority over myself. Whatever you say is my command. We have examples in the Bible. Jesus did just that. When he was approaching Golgotha, Calvary, where he was nailed to the cross, he felt the evidence of approaching death. He now said, not as I will, but your will be done, O Lord. In Hebrews chapter 10 and verse 7, it is also recorded, in the scroll, in the multitude of the book, it is written about me, I have come to do your will, O Lord. And so that is surrenderness in expression, surrenderness in practicality. I have no say, God have your way. That's what God will be doing on a daily basis. And God will help you to do just that in Jesus' name.
Amen.
Number two is to dedicate yourself more unto Him. Dedication and surrenderness, they are similar but not the same. Surrenderness is about I'm at your bidding. Do with me whatever you like. But the dedication is about putting yourself to use for God. Put yourself to His use more and more. And number three, as I conclude, pray continually. That is a ministry which you must engage yourself more than ever. Your man will say it this way, whatever is good needs prayer for sustenance. Whatever is the other way around needs prayer as well for regeneration, for transformation. And so at every time, we need prayers. And so commit yourself to the ministry of prayer according to 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 17. Pray continually. Pray unceasingly. Pray ceaselessly. At all times, engage yourself in those three things, because they will make a better you every day. They will make a better us every day. In conclusion, all of us here gathered as we rejoice to live with her and the entire family members, let me say this. Ephesians chapter 2 verse 10 says, we are created as workmanship in Christ Jesus. That is a purpose. God created us for us to be used of Him to affect other people, to better other people's lives. Whatever we are should not be solely ours. It is given us because God sees us as a steward of the resources that we are having. And that's why this family is unique. Because whatever they have, they share with people, they let privilege, they do the work of God seriously and committedly, which all of us can follow His gift from. And so as we are celebrating that today, we are also being charged that God created us, God kept us alive in order to do workmanship in His hands. Will you surrender yourself? Will I surrender myself? Because of all this we do here on earth, working in God, working for God is most beneficial. It's beneficial here on earth and in heaven where we are going. And so, the celebrant of today, Manne Rusne Odolaja, you man has a way of saying the pastor Pedika or Doka, that 20 years will just be a year. Meaning that God will satisfy you with longevity. You, your husband, the Lord will prosper you the more. All the children, you will never weep over anyone. Congratulations, congratulations, congratulations.
Amen.
is directed, the relief offering shall be collected and received at him. When upon that billows your tempest tossed, when you are discouraged, thinking of his loss, he shall rise to see.
Jesus. assume our consecration as your servants to announce the good news to the poor at the Last Supper. Christ gave to us the Eucharist that we should celebrate the memorial of the cross and resurrection and receive his presence as the bread of life. Therefore, Lord, with the angels and all the saints, we proclaim and sing your glory. Praise the Lord, God of the universe, you are holy and glorious beyond measure. Upon this sweet send your life in your spirit. With the appointment of this meal of bread and wine, make for us body and blood of Christ. May this be us with the accomplished word of your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. Who in the night in which us we pray, to pray. And when you have given thanks to, both you can give it to the disciples, say, take it. This is my body which is given for you. Do this in remembrance of me. After supper, into the cup, and when you are given time to give it to him and say, bring this all of you. This is my blood of the new covenant, who is shed for you for many for the forgiveness. Do this in remembrance of me. Therefore, Lord, as I spoke my head, so we do this in remembrance of him, and we ask that you accept the sacrifice of the grace and thanksgiving, granted by the power of the Holy Spirit, that we, who receive your little bread of mine, may share the body and blood of Christ, and grant to people everywhere the benefit of Christ in the living world. As we partake of God's body and blood, we love the Holy Spirit, that we may once in the world of our spirit in Christ, a living sacrifice of blood. We ask this through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. The peace of the Lord be always with you. I will stay the same with one another. Our Father,
Draw near with faith. Receive the body of our Lord Jesus Christ was given for you, and his blood was shed for you, and put your name in your heart by faith without skill.
The celebrant and husband can be immediately traveling with us.
The children, please by the us for prayer. Silently let us thank God for that which we have taken actually with our lips, that sin will be able to digest and be used for the progress of God's kingdom among his people and for the expansion of the sin. Let us pray in particular for the same brand, that the good Lord will grant her more years of grace, more years of fruitfulness, more years of peace and tranquility. The rest of our years will be best of our years. The rest of our days will be best of our days. Let us pray for the husband, the children, that God in his infinite mercy will be watch over them, that no evil will befall them, but rather they will walk in the region of light, of peace, of excellence throughout the days of their life. You might also pray for yourself. Today is the beginning of another month, the month of October, month of Independence, and today is our Independence Day. And Lord, you set Nigeria free 62 years ago, setting free from calamities, from manipulation, from every attack of the ignorance, and give me your grace to end this year in peace and in joy. Lord, hear our prayers. And sins that is open for the nation to those of us who are in the Lord Jesus Christ, go into the world of peace and may peace for the Lord for them to give. Shalom.
Praise the Lord.
Hallelujah.
Body is the Lord. Every other person who have come to felicitate them.
their life. Most especially, Lord, we thank you for our sister here, which we mark as sisters. It's a diamond. Lord, to you alone be all glory, honor, and adoration in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
The psalmist says, praise to the Lord. Give thanks unto his name, for his mercy endureth forever. Lord, we will be thankful for your mercies over this world. Lord, we are committing them more into your care than now. Lord, she will celebrate many more of these years in the land of the living in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
Except with her husband. Lord, they will not have any cause to weep over any of their children in the mighty name of Jesus. You have made wonderful promises to those who are his own, who are your own. Those promises we claim for them in the mighty name of Jesus.
Amen.
And then we will help you tell one of us. And that was the thing by now. Oh, Lord, we have a shame.
Amen.
In a shame, we have had that dignity and the state of the issue. So now, till we recognize that the devil will go to shame you, Mama, and shame you, Baba, and shame you. Amen. In a shame, we have found you getting your loss. And then, but we should be near about whatever we have lost. So, when it's important, we should want to go. You told us, Lord, that no weapon that is ever fashioned against us will prosper. Lord, protect them from all evil. Let them continue to have joy. Let them continue to have happiness. Let your goodness and mercy continue to abide with them all the days of their life. And so, any of you know, I'm a shallow, and any of you have power, and this woman to work and they do the shallow. Also, there are people that are living. Lord, we just thank you. Father, finally, we pray for them. You know them. You know that which they are asking you, even from the bottom of the world. Meet them at the points of their
life. Amen.
The Lord bless you.
Amen.
The Lord keep you.
Amen.
The Lord make his face to shine upon you. The Lord give the light of his countenance and the goodness of
God. Amen.
The blessing of God and the man. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Be with you both now and forever.
Amen.
As we come to the meeting service in the family, it's now time for all of us to rise from our seats to dance for all those who have thanksgiving offering, and then we'll return to our seats.
Thank you. Let us pray. Lord God, we give thanks to you for the success of this evening in our lives. We thank you for all the children who have come to join in this celebration. Lord, I pray that thanking you, Lord, to give us here. Lord, we pray that if you do a lot of times, we will live to see many more years in the land of the living, you go to that sometime in your name. Thank you, Lord, for our prayers. And give us a thank you in prayer.
Just before the benediction, the bishop just pointed out to me that we have not sung the traditional birthday song to celebrate our celebration, the 60 years of God's faithfulness. So may I then invite the celebrant and our husband to please come forward. The celebrant and our husband.
Because of the reconstruction and delays, it would be nice to start putting everybody on the vehicle to Agowin. So we pleaded with the bishop, through my bishop in Agowin, to allow us to use this edifice. Of course, I worship in Shomolu, and my presenter is there. I'm sure after now, he preached me that why can't I come to Shomolu and why Ikeja? But for a simple reason. The deception is taking place in the Kenya here. And I know Shimolu's network is a bit congested. And I don't want anybody to get lost with Shimolu. That's why That's why we decided to come here. I would say that I want to genuinely from the bottom of my heart appreciate all of us who have also identified with us in this service of Thanksgiving this morning. That's what I would say. I say a very big thank you and God bless you all. But having said that too, I want to seize the opportunity that I know that everybody here also have access code. And that means a seat is guaranteed for you at reception. The essence is that once you leave here, you should not rush at all. There can't be any mugumuya. Because anybody without access code will not be able to ingress the venue. Thank you very much, and God bless us all.
What's the name?
The Lord bless you and keep you.
Amen.
The Lord make his face to shine upon you and be gracious unto you.
Amen.
May he lift up the light of his countenance upon you.
Amen.
And give you his peace.
Amen.
Peace in your homes.
Amen.
Peace in your places of work.
Amen.
And peace to everyone that belongs to you.
Amen.
Peace to you for the remaining part of 2022 and beyond.
Amen.
Both now and forevermore.
If you have a hymn book, it is 313, 313. But if not, it will be there on the altar paper. To God be the glory, great things he hath done. So loved he the world that he gave us his Son.
Thank you. Mandy. It's a smart one.
Yes, she.
I'm going to go to the next one.
didn't get you.
I wonder if you're my chief in Adonai.
You dominated the scene. You dominated the scene.